I've taken a minute now to tidy it up, define the lines, make sure it's nice and sharp here. As I said before, I want my pot to come up and say, I'm done, I'm a casserole dish. It has to have some attitude. You can't have the attitude unless you have the clay up there and the thickness to do it. I'm going to use these tools. I'm going to use my handy dandy caliper. We've talked about it before. I'll talk about it again. And measure the lid. I like these. There's no inside measurements, no outside measurements. I'm going to make the lid, and the lid has to be this big. If I drop it, it'll still be this size. I'm going to cut it off with my wire that's hiding on the floor. I always clean the clay off on my last pot and put it on, and I'm going to pull really hard to make sure that it stays level and doesn't curl up when I'm cutting and take off half the bottom. Put my knife in there and give it a twist, as I always do. And it's going to sit over there and wait for the lid. I've got the bat ready for the wheel for the lid. Again, it's thrown separately. My little ball of clay here is ready to make a lid. Now, a lid is just an upside down bowl. I'm going to center. This is going to be a flat center. Bowl or a very deep plate. Gonna center it. I've talked about plates before, so I'll just center it and go ahead and make it. Gonna open it up again. Let this thickness not get very thin, if that makes any sense. If you want enough clay there, you have to trim this later. It has to support a knob. You want to have enough clay there to flatten it out and tidy it before you take it off the wheel. And I'm just throwing a plate. I'm just throwing straight across. My finger pressures are directly across from each other. When I want to pull clay up, they are one above the other. If I want just to move and shape the clay, they're directly across from each other. And I'm going to pull this out into a lid shape. This looks like I've got too much clay there. This is pretty thick. Take a minute and tidy it up. Make sure there's a nice transition from the bottom to the edge. And I'm going to pull this up, and I'm going to cut off a bit of clay because you really don't want a real dome top. A lot of times people making casserole dishes make the mistake of putting almost a complete bowl. You want just a curve in your lid, but not a complete upside down bowl, if that makes any sense. So you put on a ball of clay. If it's too big, make it smaller. If it's too small, you're hooped. That was kind of messy, and do that one again. And cutting off, all I'm doing is I'm holding the needle like a pen, and I'm supporting my hands and pushing it through the clay. And when the needle touches my finger, I quit pushing on the needle. I'm gonna tidy that up. Measure it again. Again, you have a nice thick edge to receive a lid. You don't want to put a little skinny wussy edge of a lid in there. What you put it on is going to be taken off and putting on, and you're going to be removing this lid and taking the lid off, putting the lid on. You will want to have a lid that will take that pressure. I'm going to measure. Still kind of big, but there's enough curve in here. We can just bowl it some more by bringing that edge in. It's not as wide. It's still big. You can cut one way or the other. Yeah, I left it big so you can see both sides of cutting. Yeah. But I do want to avoid that great big upside down bowl on there. I'm going to measure that again. That looks pretty good. That's right on. And again, we're going to cut it off, removing the casserole dish. And you want to make sure when you take it off, I've left this edge here in the clay. That's your handle. Well, you'll see that when we come back and trim it. That's the first stage of throwing a casserole, the bowl. The lid. We'll come back on this leather hard and we'll get it together.